So what I'm going to talk about is resetting your mindset for that ultimate goal. Because really, it's what you focus on is what you bring in. And what happens is that often that we spend an awful lot of time anxious, unsure, feeling worried that things aren't going to work out. And when we do that, we lose our focus. And I want to use an example to illustrate this. In 2002, I was living in Annapolis, Maryland. And I moved to Annapolis from the Adirondack Mountains because I love to sail. And it's one of the sailing capitals of the world. And I was racing 5 days a week. And I wanted to contribute back to my community, so I joined the race committee. And that's the race committee boat there. And when you're on the race committee, obviously you're officiating the races. Well, I got the opportunity to go down to Miami to the pre-trials for the Olympics for the women's Yuengling sailing team. This is our women's team, and that's my friend Liz, who looks like an L going off the boat there. And you know, when you're as athletic as these young ladies are, and as capable and talented and gifted as you are, you know that you could make it. You know that you can wear the, so to speak, prize. And it's really the difference in your mindset, whether or not you can take everything that you've been given and win, or whether you're just gonna be going there. And so what happened with Liz is I went down and I watched the pre-trials, and there she was racing, and I was all excited until about the second day when they were doing really badly. They were not doing well at all. And what I did is one day on my way home, I saw that there were two team vans, and one her van and the team that actually won the pre-trials. And on the back of her van was a bumper sticker, and it said, "On the way to Athens." On the way to Athens? You and I could be on the way to Athens, right? Might not be this year, might not be next year, but we could be on the way to Athens. And I went, wow. On the winning van, it said, "In Athens, 2004. And I said, there's the story, right there. So, although I wasn't a coach at the time, I was actually a yacht broker, I was working with a coach who knew about prosperity, mindset, and how to get the job done. In fact, it was one of the most successful times in my life working with her. So when I got back to Annapolis, I invited Liz for breakfast. And she sat down, and I looked at her, and I've always been someone who wanted to support, encourage people, get them to be all of who they are, and give them all the resources possible. So I looked at her, and I said, "So Liz, you know you're not gonna make it, right?" And she said, "Yeah, I know." I said, "Do you want to make it?" "Of course." I said, "Here's what you..." I explained about the bumper stickers, and she went, "Wow, oh my Lord." I said, "What you need to do is work with Paula. Mindset, prosperity, focus." She said, "Okay." So the next year I go down, and we're now at the trials, and there we are. Their team were so far ahead that they didn't even have to race in the last race. They were our team. Now, this is despite that the entire year at interviews, at the races, at the cocktail parties, at the races, at interviews, in the newspaper, in the magazines, they were the underdog. There was no way that they were going to the Olympics. But despite all that, so think about yourself when you get discouraged and you have people telling you, "What, are you crazy? You're never gonna make it. Why do you think you're doing that? Why would you want to invest in that? Why?" Right? Despite all that, with the right mindset, they made it. So the story had a middle happy part, and then we have a not so happy part, which is that when they went to the Olympics, they came in second in the first race. All right, they could win. They could come in second, if not first, in the Olympics. And they freaked out. They freaked out. They went, "Oh my God, we could win. Oh my God, we could win," right? And you may have had that experience in your own business. Have you ever had a good month? And then the next month, you're not doing well, and you're thinking, "Wait, what happened? Wait a minute," right? A good year, right?
Huh? Gotta get a real job.
Yeah, exactly. You go, right? What happened to me, right? And what happened to them is they came in 10th in the next race. And then they lost their courage. They lost their focus. they started to get distracted by things, you know, and what happened and why didn't we and what's wrong with us, right? And they started to doubt themselves. And when we doubt ourselves in our business, what happens is we start to not listen to our intuition. We stop. I mean, I was emailing her going, what are you doing? Right? And she said, we can't find the wind. They've only been racing every day for 4 years straight. What do you mean you can't find the wind? What do you mean? But that's how she felt. She felt like they couldn't find the wind. And they got so discombobulated that in one of the races, they actually ran into one of the race buoys.
Oh, geez.
And they came in 25th in that race. And they eventually, overall, came in 10th. So they had lots of other better races, of course, to pull that all the way up. But the point is that it turned out that Liz was the only one that believed that they could make it. So it's about you believing that you can make it, that you do have what it takes in order to get there. That's the key. Because inside of us, we have everything we need. In fact, we came into this world complete, exactly as we are. We came in with our talents, our abilities, and our gifts, which is the very essence of who we are, which I'll tell you more about later, and your feelings, which tell you exactly where you are in the moment and what you need to do next. And you came in with these fabulous bodies that you beam out to the world and you receive in from the world. And when you use all of those with a mindset and a focus that's totally focused in one area, you're able to do it. I had an experience in my life where I was very successful yacht broker, as I said, in Annapolis, Maryland. I was the second highest broker in our company, and I had only been there a few months, where other people have been there 10 years, 14 years, 32 years. And so I went down to Miami because I went to those trials. I thought, oh, I'll go to Miami. I'll sell those big boats, right? Those multi-million dollar ones. Woo-woo. I'm gonna be a millionaire. Well, I wasn't. I only sold 3 boats in 2 years, and little ones. And in Annapolis, I was selling 10 boats in a month. And talk about someone who doubted themselves, who lost who they were, forgot who they were, who struggled and stressed, and oh my goodness, and reached outside myself for the next 5 years to find something shiny. I'll just do that. No, I'll do that. No, I'll get that company. No, I'll do that company. No, I bet if I do that, I know I can do this. But I wasn't being of integrity with myself. I wasn't being who I was. And so one day when I finally had it, I closed 4 of my 5 businesses. I was working 18, 20 hours a day at that point and going nowhere. In fact, I ended up with $7 in my bank account from being worth over $1 million. So it was quite a Walt Disney World ride to the bottom. But when I woke up one day and I said, you know, that's it, I've had it, I'm out of integrity, and I closed those 4 businesses, I did one other thing. I came home and I started to write my book. I wrote my first book, and I went downstairs and I started writing, and 12 hours later I looked up and it was midnight. We're going to be talking about you unlocking your creative potential. Because every one of my clients that focuses and allow themselves to express that creative potential makes a lot of money. Some people increase their business 20%, 50%, 100%, 300%, sometimes in a week or two, literally. So when you unlock that creative potential, that gives you that that force that allows you to be able to start to believe in yourself again, because you're having fun, you're having joy, you're expressing who you really are. When you do that, then work becomes easier too. And you see, because inside this creative force, I thought you'd all think that was pretty funny this morning, right? Inside of this universal force, whatever word you want to call it, God, the universe, whatever, that keeps the earth on a 24.3 axis, that keeps us rotating around the sun rather than pivoting off into the universe, whatever that force is, when we allow ourselves to focus in on that and take that in and trust that it's there, inside is the David. Inside is our success, our creative potential, because what Michelangelo said is all he did was chip away what wasn't the David. That potential is there for you. Every moment, every day when you wake up, that That's there for you as long as you're focusing on it. And you see, it's not the direction, it's not the magnitude, it's the direction of your focus that makes the difference. So it's not how much you're doing, it's the direction that that little tiny step is going in that makes the difference. And so what you want it to do is you want it to be like the fire hose that takes your heart's desires and focuses it on one thing every day and every week, rather than when we get anxious and upset or feel not good enough or we doubt ourselves, right? We end up like watering the driveway, right? You don't want to water the driveway with your heart's desire. You want to keep it focused and on target.